In this video, we learn about the second derivative test. The second derivative test allows us to determine the nature of any stationary points along a curve's length. Now, the scenario is we're dealing with a function which has a stationary point, also known as a critical point, at x equals to c. The first derivative, f dash of x, is therefore equal to 0 at c. So f dash of c equals to 0. Then the second derivative test states that if the second derivative at c is positive, then the stationary point is a minimum. And the reason for this is because if the second derivative is positive, it means the curve is concave upwards. The stationary point must therefore be a minimum. Similarly, if the second derivative at c is negative, then the stationary point is a maximum. And the reason for this is because if the second derivative is negative, the curve must be concave downwards. The critical point must therefore be a maximum. Let's go ahead and illustrate this a little further. To illustrate the second derivative test, we're going to consider the curve defined by y is equal to 2x cubed minus 9x squared minus 24x plus 6. And that curve is shown right here. Now, looking at this, we can tell right away that somewhere here we're dealing with a local maximum, so we have a stationary point there, and we also have a local minimum here, so another stationary point. But what we'll do here is we're going to look at the first derivative to confirm where those stationary points are. That's the first thing we'll do. And then we'll use the second derivative test to see how that's used to determine whether we're dealing with a local maximum or a local minimum. So let's go ahead and do that. So the first thing we need to do is to differentiate this function. And we do that beneath the curve. So that's dy dx will equal to, using the power rule for differentiation, will be 6x squared minus 18x minus 24. And now any stationary point occurs when this derivative equals to 0. In other words, we need to figure out the solutions to dy dx equals to 0. The solutions to that are the solutions to the equation 6x squared minus 18x minus 24 equals to 0. This is a quadratic equation, and this equation has the same solutions as x squared minus 3x minus 4 equals to 0. All we've done here is divide throughout by 6. And maybe you can see it, we can solve this by factoring. Indeed, we can write that this equals to x plus 1 times x minus 4 equals to 0. If you're not comfortable factoring, you could of course solve this using the quadratic formula. But now we see that this quadratic equation has two solutions. One is x equals to negative 1. The second solution is x equals to 4. And because that quadratic equation has two solutions, this means that our first derivative is equal to 0 twice, once at x equals to negative 1, and another time when x equals to 4. So those are where our two stationary points are, confirming what we had seen on the curve before. Now that we know that those are stationary points, let's determine their nature using the second derivative test. So to do that, the first thing we need to do, of course, is to find the second derivative. And we'll do that by differentiating our derivative function. Doing that using the power rule, we find the second derivative is equal to 12x minus 18. Now that we have the second derivative, we need to use the second derivative test. And the way we do this is as follows. We look at the second derivative at each of the two stationary points, so when x equals to negative 1 and when x equals to 4. And we study the sign of the second derivative. So let's do that. At x equals to negative 1, the second derivative will be equal to the following. So we'll have 12 times negative 1 minus 18. That's equal to negative 12 minus 18, which is equal to negative 30. So at x equals to negative 1, what we notice here is that the second derivative is negative. So I'm just writing that there. And because it's negative, it means that at this stationary point, the curve must be concave downwards. And so we're dealing with a stationary point at which the curve is concave downwards. It must therefore be a maximum. Now we do the same at x equals to 4, the second stationary point. At x equals to 4, the second derivative is, so we have d squared y dx squared equals to 12 times 4 minus 18. That's equal to 48 minus 18, and that's equal to 30. So at x equals to 4, the second derivative is positive. That means that at this stationary point, the curve is concave upwards. Therefore, we're dealing with a stationary point at which the curve is concave upwards. It therefore must be a minimum point. And that's how the second derivative test works. We look at the sign of the second derivative at any stationary point, and depending upon whether it's positive or negative, we'll be dealing with either a local minimum or a local maximum. Remember, if the second derivative is positive, it means the curve is concave upwards, therefore we're dealing with the minimum. If the second derivative is negative, it means the curve is concave downwards, we're therefore dealing with a maximum. I hope that helps.